Hello, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. It is good to see you again in the series of Management Accounting. In this session, we will discuss about the job costing part 2, which is related to the spoilage, rework and scrap. It's me. Okay, our learning objective in this session is to learn about the definition of spoilage, rework and scrap. And then we will learn about the type of spoilage. The third is the normal spoilage and the related journal entries, and also the abnormal spoilage and the related journal entries. Next, we will discuss about the rework and scrap and the related journal entries as well. Let's recall the basic terminology that we will use in this session. The first one is spoilage. Spoilage is unit of production, whether it is fully or partially completed, that do not meet the specification required by customers for good units, and this kind of units can be discarded or can be just sold, but with a lower price, of course. Yeah, the lower than the normal product or good product. Next is rework. Rework is the unit of production that do not meet the specification required by customers either, but the company can redo, can repair the product, and it can be then sold as good finished good or good units. So it is can be sold together with other good units. Next is scrap. Scrap is the residual material. Yeah, it is result from the manufacturing process. So the value of the scrap is usually low. Yeah, relatively very low compared to the product that the company has normally. Okay. We have two kinds of spoilage, normal spoilage and abnormal spoilage. Yeah, normal spoilage is the spoilage that is inherent. So this is normally incurred in the production process, even though the production process has been done efficiently. So in other words, we cannot, or it is very hard to avoid the normal spoilage. And because this is normal, we assume that the cost of the spoilage should be borne by other good units. Yeah, so the cost of the normal spoilage is assigned to good units. Yeah, for example, if we produce, let's say, 100 units, and it costs, let's say, 1 million. Yeah, but 3 units is spoilage, let's say, normally. So the 1 million cost should be divided into the 97 good units. So it will increase the cost per unit of the good units. Okay, so usually the management will make a normal standard how much normal spoilage is controllable by the company. Let's say if it is 2%, so if the company produce 100 units, it means that 2 units is expected to be spoilage. If it is more than 2%, or more than 2 units, it means that the spoilage is not normal. That's what we call as abnormal spoilage. So abnormal spoilage that is spoilage that is not inherent in the production process. Yeah, so it is actually can be avoid. Yeah, so it is avoidable and controllable, and it is assumed that abnormal spoilage will incur only if the process is not efficient enough, or if there is something wrong with the production. Yeah, and because this is something that is avoidable, and then the cost incurred, so the cost will be recognized as loss from abnormal spoilage. So the loss from abnormal spoilage will appear in the income statement separately, while if it is normal, the normal spoilage cost will be included in the other normal goods, in other good units. So we will not see the normal spoilage in the income statement, but the abnormal spoilage can be traced, can be seen in the income statement. Yeah, so the management can see, oh okay, this is our normal abnormal spoilage now, and it means that there is something wrong with the production process. So the company then can see what they can do to fix up the condition. Let's see now the accounting related to the normal spoilage. Yeah, normal spoilage should be divided into two kinds. Whether it is attributable to a specific job, or normal spoilage can also be incurred in the normal or common to all jobs. Yeah, the cost of normal spoilage that is attributable to a specific job will be assigned to the cost of the specific job, yeah, the good units of the specific job. So then the cost of the specific job will be incurred by that job, and we have to deduct it with the disposal value of the spoilers. Let's say the spoilers can be sold, for example, so it will be net of the disposal value of the spoilage. So the journal entry of the normal spoilage attributable to a specific job is journalized to the working process, yeah, for a particular job. But if the normal spoilage is a common to all jobs, so it is costed as manufacturing overhead, yeah, because it is common to all jobs. And the journal entry would be debit to the manufacturing overhead control. Okay, if the spoilage is considered abnormal, yeah, so the net loss is charged to the loss from abnormal spoilage account, as we discussed before. So it is not included as part of the cost of goods sold unit products, yeah. And the journal entry will be recognized as loss from abnormal spoilage. Okay, credit to the work in process control. Let's now move to rework. Yeah. Rework can be normal and can be abnormal as well. The normal rework can be attributable to a specific job, or it is common to all jobs. If it is attributable to a specific job, so the cost of the rework is charged to that job, to that particular job. So the journal entry is debit working process, and the credit is the material control for the material of the rework, wages for the labor that do the rework, and overhead allocated for the overhead costs incurred to that particular job. And if it is normal rework common to all jobs, it is assigned to the manufacturing overhead. Yeah, so you see here that the debit is manufacturing overhead control. And if it is abnormal, again the same as the spoilage, abnormal spoilage, we assign the cost to the loss from abnormal rework. Yeah, and again it will appear in the income statement. So you can see here that the debit is loss from abnormal rework. The last one is scrap. Yeah, scrap is a residual materials that result from manufacturing a product. Yeah, the value is very low and no cost is assigned to scrap. Yeah, because no distinction is made between normal and abnormal, and there is no distinction is made between normal and abnormal scrap, because this is just a scrap, yeah, so there is no cost is assigned to scrap. And but we can divide the scrap into specific job or common to all jobs. Let's see now the accounting. Yeah, we can recognize scrap in at the time of its sale or at the time of its production. Let's see now the first one as the recognizing at the time of its sale. If the scrap is considered as immaterial, and then we can then sell that scrap, so we recognize that revenue, that cash receipt from the customer or from the sale of the scrap as the scrap revenues. But if it is material, you know, so we have to find whether it is attributable as or to specific job, or it is whether it is common to all job. If it is attributable to specific job, when we return it back to the store room, so there is no journal we have to prepare. But when the scrap is sold, then we recognize the sale as the deduction of the work in process control. You can see that the work in process control is credit. It means that it deducts the cost of work in process of that specific job. But if it is common to all jobs, so we recognize it as the manufacturing control. So it will deduct the cost of the manufacturing overhead. Okay, next is when the scrap is recognized, yeah, at the time of its production. Yeah, if the job, if the cost is or the scrap is attributable to a specific job, when we return it to the storeroom, this is the journal entry that we have to make. Yeah, so we have to recognize back the material control, and it will deduct the work in process control. But if it is common to all job, when we return to the storeroom, so the credit will be manufacturing overhead control. But if it is when we sell the scrap, yeah, we will deduct it from the material control. Yeah, so it will deduct the material control. So we do not recognize the scrap revenues. Yeah, the same case for the specific job as well. So it will just deduct it from the material control, but we recognize cash. Yeah, so in other words, it deduct the cost of the specific job. And sometimes the scrap can be reused sometimes. If this is the case, so we when we return it back to the storeroom, so we recognize it as the material control, yeah, and it deduct the manufacturing overhead control, because if it is common to all jobs. When we reuse the scrap, we recognize it as the work in process control. So because there is no cash we receive it, because there is no sale, so we just reuse it, so it will be assigned to the work in process control. Okay, I think this is all for today for this session, job costing related to the spoilage and rework and scrap. Yeah, thank you for your attention. Hope that it will be beneficiaries for you, and you can understand the material. See you again in the next topic. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.